Hello students, welcome back to our biology class, day 5 online session. In previous week or in previous classes, we have learnt about infectious diseases and our immune system and the components of immune system, that is lymphoid organs, primary and secondary lymphoid organs, antibodies and the lymphoid tissue. We have learned to fight to give immunity in our body. So we have also learned that the immunity is the types of immunity we acquire during our lifetime or by birth. So based on that, that is innate immunity and acquired immunity. Innate immunity is pathogen, it's not pathogen specific, and it is inherited from our parents, and it is accomplished by certain barriers in our body, like physical, physiological, cytokine, cytological barriers. And also in the acquired immunity is by producing two types of antibodies like B cells and T lymphocytes, which are produced from bone marrow and thymus. And also the type of immune response we give towards these pathogens. We learn that one is humoral immune response and cell mediated immune response. In humoral immune response, as we know, the humor, that is body fluids, which develop antibodies against these pathogens to fight against, to kill them. And in cell-mediated immune response, there is no involvement of antibodies, but it is due to the activation of macrophages, natural killer cells, antigen-specific T lymphocytes, cytokines, and all these together to fight against these diseases. So today we are going to learn about the types of immunity based on the antibodies produced inside the body or outside the body. Our immunity can be distinguished into active immunity and passive immunity, based on the antibodies produced inside or outside the body. Inside the body is an example for active immunity. If it is produced outside, it is a passive. So that means if any antigen is invading or attacking our body, antibodies will be produced against. It can be induced artificially also. If passive immunity, that means it's you are given from outside. It can be natural and artificial. That means naturally also antibodies come from outside and through, just like an example, like maternal antibodies through the placenta and also through the breastfeeding we can give, and also artificially. How is it? We will be learning in detail now. What is vaccination? When you introduce an antigen, it is a vaccine. It can be in a weak pathogen or inactivated pathogen or any protein to develop antibodies against it in your body. Okay, that means when you have given some antigen, our body automatically starts producing antibodies against it to that vaccine as a primary response. So during primary response, what happens? Our immunity system will develop memory cells called B cells and T cells. And when the second time, if at all the same pathogen is attacking our body, they produce an intense immune response to kill that pathogen. That means through vaccination, you are inducing immunization in the body. This is the antibodies, you are making antibodies to produce inside your body. Sometimes you require immediate immune response because the making antibodies inside your body will take time. So if you require immediate response, sometimes you can inject antibodies from outside to kill the pathogen. For example, if you take snake bite, if snake venom is that antigen entered into your body, it will affect our nervous system. So by the time the body responds, and because there is no memory cells for that antigen, so by the time the antibodies will react to that snake venom, it takes snake venom, you may die. That's why you have to provide some injections like antitoxins so that venom effect will be suppressed. So this is called passive immunization. That means you are providing antitoxins or antibodies from outside to give immediate effect. The same case with the tetanus also. And nowadays we are producing hepatitis B vaccine through rDNA technology, which is developed from the yeast cells. So vaccination and immunization is vaccination provides immunization after a time gap. It is based on our memory cells of our immune system. So it is based on our the memory cells. Our immune system not only respond to the pathogens or microbes, sometimes it may also give hypersensitive reaction or exaggerated response to certain chemicals or antigens present in our environment. And this type of hypersensitive exaggerated response is called allergy. The substances which are causing this allergy or immune response are called allergens. Generally, in the environment, the allergens we found are pollen grains, animal dander, dust, feathers, and drugs like penicillin, etc. So the response our body is giving by producing antibodies, most of the time the antibodies produced in the body are IgE type. So which are causing this allergic reactions in our body is because our mast cells produce some chemicals like histamine and serotonin, which are causing these symptoms like sneezing, watery eyes, runny nose. If it is more response, then it shows a difficulty in breathing also. The kind of treatment we will take for immediate relief is by giving antihistamine drugs or adrenaline and steroid drugs so that we can stop that allergy symptoms. And these are the four types of hypersensitive reactions produced by our immune system against those allergens. This is not given on our textbook. This is not in the syllabus. But still, you can have an idea what type of reactions will happen towards those allergens like pollen and dust. Normally, our immunity system can tell the difference between foreign cells and your own cells. But if it is losing that property, then it is rejecting its own body cells or self cells or molecules because of some unknown reasons or some genetic modification, resulting in a disease called autoimmune disease, and this is called autoimmunity. That means your body is producing antibodies against your own cells. So that means it is mistakes part of your body like your joints or skin or as a foreign particle, and it releases proteins called autoantibodies which attack the healthy cells. Generally, the autoimmune diseases we can see in our bodies, rheumatoid arthritis and diseases where immune system is attacking the joints, and this attack causes redness in the joint and soreness and stiffness, and this is one kind of autoimmune disease. So with this we are learning about we finished our immune system and our immunity. Please go and watch these videos as a help for the overall revision or to understand more about the immunity system. So go through the YouTube videos and you can have a better understanding about this after going through our PPTs. Okay.